I'm running events and traveling all around the world and really promoting and progressing Kendama to the limits, and I love every second of it. I get to wake up every morning and I love what I do, and I don't think a lot of people get to say that about even their job. I really don't even look at Kendama as my job. I look at it as me playing Kendama and me living my life how I want to live my life, and it just so happened to work out that I can work and do what I love. My home turf. It's good to be back, you know, out here filming the beautiful locations all throughout the summer. This is where I started playing Kendama 5 years ago with Turner. You know, we would go out, play Kendama, film everywhere. This is what we did all summer long. And it's good to be back, you know, where my home turf is. Seeing myself when I first started playing Kendama, I really didn't expect that I'd be here now. Living in San Diego, with how big the scene is, with where I've traveled and the amount of experience I've had, you know, through Kendama. So it's been a crazy ride, but I've enjoyed every minute of it. Refreshing to be able to come back home and play Kendama in Lake Tahoe, probably one of the most beautiful places on this planet Earth. You know, with all the traveling I've been doing and the multiple events I've been hosting and all the really great opportunities that have come my way, it's a breath of fresh air to, you know, step back and experience the roots of where I started playing Kendama in the first place. When a new event comes my way, I get to show up and meet a whole new group of players. And as much as they look up to me and how stoked they are to hang out with me and play Kendama with me, I'm equally as stoked to do the same thing, to play Kendama, to teach them, because they inspire me to become a better Kendama player, to push myself to progress and continue to do what I love to do. Moving down to San Diego, I had already known there was a Kendama scene. So luckily when I got down there, I was able to, you know, hit up shops that had already had our product, maybe visit some shops that didn't have our product yet, and really try and figure out if we could do some sort of collab work to where I'd be able to hold an event, I'd be able to hang out the kids and all the Kendama players that were there and really teach them exactly what Kendama is. I really want to try and push the educational value of why we started playing Kendama. We started playing Kendama because we love playing it. We would get together with our friends after school, or, you know, if we're on a team, or go have a barbecue and hang out in the backyard and just jam Kendama with no worries. Just get together with your friends, get a camera, and just grind out some tricks and have some fun doing it. Because that's really what it's all about. Like this guy over here. We'll be right back. one thing that I really like to hear, and great feedback from parents, is that it's Kendama is steering their kids away from technology, as far as video games, TVs, iPads, iPhones, and I think that's a super crucial point in our generation, or the, you know, the future generation, because we're so caught up in all the technology and Facebook and what's on the internet that Kendama is such a good gateway to go outside, play with your friends, jam Kendama, listen to music, and do something that has no batteries, has no involvement with technology.
It's always nice to, you know, get together with my teammates and jam a little music, play some Kendama, and, you know, relive the roots of when we all first started playing Kendama back in the day. We all know Colin Sanders edit 7, and all of Colin Sanders' edits are just pure gold because he just plays Kendama. So, yeah, the roots of Kendama, it's where it stands, and that's where it starts. It wasn't that time of sun, but we're finished. Peace out. Thanks for watching.